Andrew?
Yes, sir.
Alrighty. Well, let's see here. Where are we going?
Dakota? Farmington.
Oh, okay. Alright.
Well, yeah, getting out of here is going to be fun.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be real fun. Not the best place to park.
No.
Oh, jeez. Okay. All right. So I bet you've heard about Victory, haven't you?
Oh, yeah.
What do you think of the way they handled that?
Oh. Easier just go out that way.
Yeah, I think I'm going to put this back here.
You're clear now.
Okay, good. So do you think what they did was a stupid move, or you think it was
what are you talking about?
Well, like where they just decided to not do any more Victory motorcycles where...
Okay. Watch these ladies.
Just, why don't they just...
You're good now.
Okay. Alright, so do you think it was a wise decision for them to do that? Because I guess if the demand wasn't there, then there was no need for it.
Right.
But...
Yeah?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, because it just seems like it's kind of crazy to be in business for all those years.
Yeah, and then just up and
quit. Yeah, and I'm starting to wonder if they were making production bikes, kind of like what Honda does, or
right.
Suzuki, which to me, what that does is it... produces more overhead.
I definitely understand that.
Yeah, so I'm starting to wonder if they just fell into that foreign made kind of thing.
Yeah.
Like that.
They couldn't produce them as cheap.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And one thing I've noticed, at least, because see, I have a 2014 Honda CTX 1300.
Oh, okay.
And they made this motorcycle for only one freaking year, and that was it. And I'm going, God, you know, 6 months they decide that they're not. After 6 months, they decide, we're not going to make it anymore.
Right.
And I'm going, oh my God, and I got the bike with an MSRP. Seemed like when I got it over at the dealership, it was about 19 grand. Which, that doesn't make any sense, but then again, you have to add the destination and all that kind of stuff.
Right.
And then the bank only financed for that much. And it's only, the MSRP is what, probably about 17. So, banks got to get their money somehow.
Right.
I guess. So, but I think the problem with Honda and, like I said, other ones is they overproduce, and then I guess what they do is they expect that their sales is going to match their overproduction.
Yeah.
Sometimes it doesn't turn out that way. So, it makes you wonder.
That's what caused it.
Yeah.
Right.
And then you look at something like Harley-Davidson.
Yeah.
And look at how long they've been in business.
Oh, yeah. A long time.
And it seems like, granted, Harley-Davidson has had bankruptcies and all that. But what's to say no other business has had that?
Yeah, no.
Yeah. So, I'm thinking that Harley is probably, should be the I guess you could say the role model for these other motorcycle companies that should not produce so much.
Yeah.
And then they don't have overhead, then reduce the cost. And then the resale value, I think, will go up.
Yep.
Yeah, see, like mine, man, resale value when I got it, and now I can only get it for about a trade-in value of about $7,000. Huh. And then I got like 11,000 left to pay on this crazy thing.
I know how that goes.
Yeah, see, and just imagine the negative equity I have.
Oh, yeah.
God.
There's a lot of cars like that out there, too.
Yeah. God. Like, okay. Anyway. So, yeah, the car, it doesn't matter now, I guess. Cars, motorcycles, boats, you know, whatever. It's insanity.
Right.
And I really think that there needs to be something done about this, because, like, even with my motorcycle, it left me high and dry so far as finances, not mechanically yet.
Yeah.
But financially, yeah, it has.
Yeah, there's no way. No way you can get your money out of that.
Yeah.
Right now, anyways.
Yeah. So that's what's just so frustrating for me, and probably in a lot of other CTX 1300 owners.
Yep. I can see that.
Yeah.
I mean, Harleys hold their value pretty good.
Yeah.
Just about anything else.
Yeah. It's like they don't hold their value, and then when it comes down to selling it, now you're stuck between a rock and a hard place.
Yep. Absolutely.
Now, I'm thinking that, well, with my bike, I'm wondering if I should keep it, which I probably will end up doing, because it's a collector's item now.
Right.
And just keep adding, I guess, onto it. Now, I took a trip over to Peel Ferry. Oh gosh, it was about 2 weeks ago. So I got on that ferry. Up there, it's where Bull Shoals Lake is.
Okay.
So I got up on that ferry, and actually, when I left Springdale, it was about 40 degrees. By the time I got home, it was a good maybe 20. So, and then I start thinking, okay, what do I need to improve rides in the future? Do I need So, do I need heated gear? Do I need grips, heated seat? What do I need? But that trip actually taught me a lot, because then I started thinking, okay, now what am I going to need? And the heated grips and the heated seat, granted, they'd be good on the Goldwing.
Right.
And it's also, Goldwing's got like a heated vent that you can aim the heat from the engine onto your feet.
Huh. That's interesting.
Yeah, that's something I think that I'm not even sure Harley has.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, I'll have to look into that. But wearing heated gear, I started thinking about it, because on my way back, I'd say it's right around Alpena, the fingertips were really starting to freeze.
So you don't want those to freeze.
Yeah. And now I'm starting to think, okay, heated grips, yeah, they may be good for a point. Then it's those fingertips.
Right.
And especially cold, gotta think about the legs too. So I'm thinking heated gear is probably gonna be my best bet. And then I just hook it up into the motorcycle, and there's like a pigtail I've got on my motorcycle. So it's something that you can hook in like for a battery charger or something like that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so I'm trying to decide Gerbing or Zedici as the heated gear. And Gerbing has got a military grade kind of thing that will heat up within about 3 seconds. So, and then the Zedici, I don't really know a lot about that. But I do know that some moto vloggers on YouTube, like Chris Cavalcante, use it. So,
It sounds like it'd keep you warm.
Yeah. Yeah, and just even with that little thing, to me, it really.
It's a lift here.
Okay. And to me, it really proved beyond a shadow of a doubt that when you ride a motorcycle in cold weather, even if you're layered, still, like I was, it still isn't enough.
Right.
So,
yep.
I'm at that point now. Okay, so I need to save up for heated gear, and I'm wondering what should be the first gear I need to get. Would probably be the gloves. And then the jacket is
in the
hands.
Good investment for sure.
Yeah. So.
Is this
right here?
Yep.
Okay. So. I've got to probably do it in stages. Because. Okay. Yeah, I've got to probably do it in stages because.
Oh, yeah. Can't buy it all at once, no?
Yeah.
It's gonna be a lift.
Okay. Yeah, like the Gerbing is, even a completed suit be about $700 or $800.
No, wow.
So.
Yeah, it's best to keep adding on left here.
Okay.
And then you can go to the stop sign, take another left.
Okay. So, anyway, I do like riding in the cold, but
right.
there's a fine line.
Yeah, give and take.
Yeah, and
left.
Right here in this house here?
No, keep going. You're gonna take another left.
Okay.
Kind of cold second.
Oh, okay.
And then it's going to be where the porch light's on, down on the right.
Oh, okay. Let's
see. You can actually just drop me off by that truck. That's my truck.
Oh, okay. That blue truck there?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. You have a good evening.
You too. Good luck on that gear.
Yeah, thanks. Talk to you later.
Bye.
All right, y'all. Well, that was an interesting conversation. So, I am out of here. I will talk to you all in a little bit. How you doing tonight?
Not too bad.
Hi again.
Oh, that's good.
How are you doing?
Oh, I'm doing okay. I guess this is going to be my last fare for the evening because then I'm going to go home. I usually go to about 3 o'clock in the morning. I don't get to bed till about 4. So, yeah, I've got to stop doing that.
Well, I mean, spring break's about to start. I think it's kind of slow tonight, too, right?
Yeah. It was kind of slow. It seems to pick up as the night goes on, but I swear there'd be some crazy things happening during the week. So I think there's like one that is during Christmas they call it Kappa Kissmas. I don't know if you ever heard of that. It's crazy.
Yeah, but I believe that. College.
Yep, exactly. So, and then I think they had one that was a Tinder kind of thing.
You gotta stay away from those two people.
Yeah.
They're just trouble.
Exactly. And I've even had the app, and it just seems like, then it seems like no one ever gets in contact. So, I'm like, okay. So I got rid of that Tinder app.
Yeah.
I hate that thing. You never meet anybody on that.
Yeah, it's almost like it's a crapshoot, basically.
I mean, you never know what you're going to get to, right?
Yeah.
Like, the person doesn't imagine to be a total creep.
Yeah, it's true. And some of the things I've gotten were, oh yeah, we can meet, but only if you go to this website. Say here, so it says it's to verify who you are. So because I don't feel safe on a date. I'm going, okay. So I gotta go to this crazy website. Probably pay so much for them to verify that I'm not a psychopath.
They don't know.
But I tell you what, I've had to deal with, and I'd say the past probably 7 years, or 8, I've had to deal with at least 2 problems. That one, I tried to get her to go to a premarital counselor because she wanted to marry me, and I go, okay, well, let's just go to a premarital counselor. She had a 7-year-old daughter, and I'm going, okay, I've got the appointment set up, and she goes, oh, great, and then the appointment day comes, and then she says, oh, I'm sorry, I can't. I go, why? She goes, oh, I just can't, it's because of my daughter. I'm going, it involves her too. I'm not gonna leave her out of this. You know, it's a seven-year-old kid. So I never did quite understand that. And then the next couple days go by, she decides to leave me for a guy that beat her and her daughter, physically beat her and her daughter. So, and she told me, I just don't understand why I meet craziest guys. Going, I'm crazy. I think you probably need to look at yourself in the mirror. Oh gosh. And that was the end of that relationship. But I even put down money on a house that she didn't even want, and she ended up putting. She ended up putting about zero money toward it, and I did.
So that's not good.
Yeah. So, see, I think I'm gonna have to turn around here. Telling me to go over on Green Acres. So, And then the one bit, and then the one after her was even crazier. So
I think you should just stay away from all of them.
Yeah.
They're all crazy.
Yeah, I'm starting to wonder that too.
Except for you, man.
Yeah.
Okay, you're a little crazy.
Well.
Yeah, we are.
Yeah. See, she's admitting it. She's like, yeah, you should stay away.
Oh, okay. I guess I need to go MGTOW. And then going their own way.
Well, you know what? You can't even go the other direction because the guys are just as bad.
Yeah.
So I might as well stay with the crazies.
Yeah. Yeah. I think I might just stay single.
That's always an option.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's see here. Yeah, I miss Sycamore. So, but anyway, yeah, the other girl, she ran off with a $6,000 engagement ring. And not only that, she was just a little bit Looney Tunes.
But $6,000 is still cheap if you compare it to how bad it could have been, right?
Oh, yeah. Now that I think about it, yeah. But I wonder sometimes. And she tried to kill herself on more than one occasion. One was she ended up trying to take a serrated knife in my house and try to slit her wrist with that. This is after the cops, Springdale cops, had followed me to my house and told me to keep her off the road. And I didn't know that she was intoxicated with all the antidepressants, anti-anxiety, panic attacks. So I just told the officer, okay, officer, I will keep her here in my house. So, yeah. Yeah. So, I'm at that point where I just start wondering, okay, do I need to start asking the women I date for a background check? Psychological background check.
They're trying to stay away from that crazy.
Yeah. The only question is, how do I? When they seem to all gravitate toward me.
Or maybe you gravitate towards them.
I don't know.
Yeah, a little bit of both, right?
Yeah, maybe.
Well, we all like a little bit of crazy.
Yeah. I just know Lorena Bobbitt.
Next.
Yeah, that would be about that.
Yeah.
We'll save you a lot of money in condoms, though.
Yeah, that's true. That is very true.
All yeah. Oh, the way short
is
the
back. Okay. And right now, I'm concentrating on getting my credit score up and this and that. Because I want to get me a house.
That's good.
Do you mind waiting 1 minute and I'll put in the next address?
Okay.
You can come in with me if you want. If you don't mind waiting out here by yourself for like a few minutes.
I don't mind waiting.
It won't be long at all.
Okay.
I just have to like grab a few clothing items.
We'll be able to get it back out.
Alright. Trip just as soon as I complete the trip. Like I said, I can't go on doing this 2:30 in the morning. That's just too much. But yeah, so just waiting for them to get a few clothing and, you know, be off on their journey yet again. We'll see what happens. We'll just keep waiting for them. It should be. Should be coming out pretty soon. Oh, Jesus. Just wait. Well. Hopefully they come back. Alright, I'm gonna end it right here and then I'll pick it up when they come back. We'll see what happens. But anyway, talk to you all in a little bit. Alrighty, here we go. Let's see. So have you all heard about the whole Victory fiasco?
No, what was that?
Oh gosh, where they decided that they just weren't going to make any more motorcycles anymore.
Victory? Like motorcycles?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, I guess they decided that, well, since they're partially owned by Polaris, that they just weren't going to make them anymore. And I guess it's because of the fact that they were just, I guess, I don't know, probably overproducing.
Or the brand demand. Just worth so much.
Yeah, you would think. I mean, I would love to have a Victory, especially like a cross country, or even their Vision. That looked nice. So, but yeah, Victory just decided they weren't going to do it anymore. So now it's Harley Davidson and Indian.
Oh, just give it, like, the same thing that has happened before. The same thing happened to Indian, actually. The brand is worth so much. It's got so much history. Somebody's going to buy it.
Yeah.
And they'll bring the bikes back. Because the reality is, as much as you want to talk about in those bikes, you're not buying the motorcycle or how good of a bike they are.
Yeah.
It's the legacy of what they stand for.
Like, yeah.
Harley Davidson, it's an incredibly powerful brand, but they are actually, technology-wise, they're not the best motorcycle out there. They're way behind it, but people love it, that they're loud. And that, you know, the brakes are not the best. It's like, you want a good bike? Get a Honda, get a Suzuki.
Yeah.
They're actually, technology-wise, way safer, more efficient, whatever you want. The engines are much better.
Yeah.
But they don't have that essence, that history, that legacy, that when you turn it, you hear it, and you know it's a Harley. A good bike or indifferent, it is a Harley.
Right.
And when's the last time you saw a guy walking around with a tattoo of Honda?
I don't know. I have yet to do that.
But how many guys do you see on Blues Bikes and Barbecue with Harley Davidson all over their arm or chest or shoulder?
Oh, yeah.
Because that brand, like, defines them and who they are, and they belong to something bigger.
Well, yeah, because it's like the Hog Club.
Yeah.
So, the Harley Owners Group, I think that's what they call it. But yeah, the only thing is, I mean, Harley has pretty much made their bikes to where resale value is there, whereas like my bike that I got back in 2014 ain't worth crap, right? No, it really is not worth crap.
No, if you want a bike that's not worth crap, look at a Honda or a Suzuki. You can get a Shadow for $3,000 that was like 3 years old.
Yeah.
With like, you know, 30,000 miles, not even on it.
Yeah.
And it was like, it's a good bike, there's nothing wrong with it. I mean, it's lost 60%, 70% of its value in 2 years.
Yeah.
Harley stick to hold it a little bit better, you know?
Yeah. And I'm thinking the reason they do that is because it's not a mass production bike. Harleys aren't mass produced. Like,
well, and it's kind of like Jeeps. Jeeps actually don't devalue because whether you have 2007 or 2012, you actually can't really tell the difference.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And because you don't change them that much, they pretty much are able to hold their value pretty well.
Oh, okay.
I mean, you can look at a Harley from the 1980s and a Harley from a couple of years ago. Yeah. You could say they are pretty much the same line, the same feel, they sound the same.
Yeah.
They run similar, you know. So why should you really devalue it other than the wear and tear?
Right.
Versus, I joke with people and they're like, I mean, gee, why don't you drive a BMW?
Yeah.
I'm like, well, you know, because this year I buy a BMW, I have a brand new BMW.
Right.
And next year I have last year's BMW.
Right.
And 3 years from now, I have the last series of BMWs, and they've lost 60% its value in 3 years.
Yeah.
It's like I have an old BMW. I like classic cars because, honestly, every year they just get older.
Exactly.
Like, I have a 64 and a half Mustang convertible.
Oh, wow.
And again, next year, you know what it is? Yeah. It's still a 64 and a half Mustang convertible.
Yeah.
And just got a little bit older, so it didn't lose any value. If anything, it probably gained a little.
Well, yeah, and it's probably an antique car now.
Yeah.
So.
Plus, I'll tell you, it's funny because whenever I would drive around in that car, like, I used to get a girl that drove like a Mercedes, a brand new one.
Okay.
Everywhere I drove, people would stop and honk and like wave. And she's like, you know what? My car is worth 10 times more than yours. And nobody stops me to wave or say hi. Like, no, because yours, there's like a bunch of dolls all over the place and you're pretentious.
Yeah.
This is something fun, something unique.
Yeah. It's the way it's made, I guess. And German made stuff seems to also last too.
Yeah.
So but yeah, if you ever on YouTube, I'm Renegade Biker 24.
Oh, nice.
So
yeah, we were actually just talking about motorcycles earlier on today.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because I really, really want to meet the motorcycles.
Oh, yeah. Actually,
all blacked out.
Oh.
It's such a sleek bike, you know.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I think I rode it in the Bikes, Blues, and Barbecue.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I'm not sure if I still have it on my channel, but it'd be under Bikes, Blues, and Barbecue playlist.
Yeah.
On Renegade Biker 24, so you can check it and see. Yeah. The only thing is, yeah, I ended up getting a new, I guess you could call it a motor vlogging camera. Now I have a Senna 10C. And what ended up happening is I had one of those GP10s that I put on the back of this GoPro.
Uh-huh.
And the problem was that the crazy thing would not transfer the audio to the video.
Oh, that's weird.
Yeah. And it ended up quitting on me the third day in Bikes, Blues, and Barbecue. So it's like, damn. Okay. So I ended up having to tell Zena about it. Excuse me. And they told me to send it back, yet I haven't sent it back yet. I've thought about just taking a sledgehammer and stupid thing and destroying it. But then again, that would be considered hazardous waste, and I'm not a big fan of
doing sometimes it just feels so good.
Yeah.
Versus dealing with customer service and all their stuff.
Yeah. And then they'll tell you, well, you gotta have this right number and this and that. And I'm like, oh, God. So anyway, so that's what I use right now is the Cine 10C. It's a Bluetooth communicator slash camera. So if you go on my channel, you'll see some of the videos I uploaded, and the ones I've gone, or the ones I've gone and used the Cine 10C is stuff like I went up to Peel Ferry recently, or well, actually it's Peel, but take that ferry across Bull Shoals Lake, and I went up there, and when I got there, gosh, it was cold. When I first started out from Springdale, it was really, really, really cold, like about 40 degrees. Then by the time I got back to Springdale, it was a good, said about 30 degrees, but just subtract about another 10 or 15 degrees. And that's what it's like on a motorcycle.
Well, I mean, once you have the wind blowing,
Yeah, so, and this state is known for its wind, so I'm going to deal with that, but I am looking at getting some good heated gear, because it's either heated gear or like heated grips and heated seat. But after that experience that I've had, my fingertips were all frozen.
You're gonna go all the way down to that stop sign.
Okay.
Turn left.
Okay. So I've really debated on what I need to get, the, like I said, the heated gear or the heated grips and seat for my bike, but I'm thinking the heated gear is probably going to be the best bet, because the heated grips and the heated seat would be good for a little bit, but still.
It's very first to the left.
Oh, okay, right here?
Yep, and it's the very last house to the right.
Oh, okay.
See that.
Alright. So. But anyway, yeah, that's what I'm working toward right now, and I'm just going to try and get the heated gear in stages, I guess you could say. So it'll be like gloves first, and then jacket, and on and on.
So that's right here on the right.
On the right? Okay. Alrighty.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Y'all have a nice evening. I am heading home. I am heading home because this is it for me. Alright, y'all. I will talk to you all later. after this last trip, see, it says 137.36, but it's still processing. So we will see what happens. But anyway, y'all, I am going to end it here, and we'll see. Well, what kind of goes on from here, but I am heading home, and I will talk to you all later. Okay, y'all, well, I now have a total of 151.38.
Not a
federal holiday or something like that. So, I mean, it's amazing, at least for me, on how busy it has become just right now. But anyway, that's really all I've got for you for tonight's vlog. And I am going to head on home, and I'm going to, like I said, I'm going to try and get some of the previous vlogs from last night up on my channel, so we will see what happens. And we'll see how well this turns out. And I do have the microphone up. It's the boom mic. It's up above on the visor. So that's where I have it right now. I don't have a lapel mic because, well, let's just face it, the Chinese lapel mics are a piece of beep. But I have to look into the other lapel mic. And the other Chinese lapel mic that's, I'm not sure if that is a piece of beep, but we'll see. But anyway, this is Renegade Biker 24, and I am in my 2013 Chevy Spark, and I will talk to you all later.